Hello and welcome to Edutinews YouTube channel. My name is Harsh Singh, and in this video, we shall discuss the current affairs and gazette for today, that is 7th of January 2021. Welcome and good evening to all the participants. Good evening to all the people who are here joining live with us. And we are delayed for today because we had the essay discussion. How was the discussion? How was the essay quick analysis discussion for all of you, friends? Good evening to all of you. Good evening, Anvam. Hi, Anonymous. Hi, Hima. Hello to... Then we have Bhavani. Good evening to you. Hi, Netra. Hi, Ashish. Hi, Pooja. Good evening, Surya. Good evening to all of you. Sir, are you in quarantine? What do you think, sir? What do you think? Yes, I am in quarantine right now. There are a few people and around me. I have been in contact. And that is the reason I am trying to secure some level of morality for society by being isolated from the society, right? So, how was your discussion for essays? Please tell me. So, told to follow a few books other than GS paper. Any books you can follow? I would say you follow current affairs and we deal with it all together, right? Sir is one person who has got very, very wide experience in this field. He has been teaching essays also for quite a while. And yes, we also do have certain understanding about essays. So we'll discuss it slowly and steadily. We'll keep sharing with you updates on the same, right? So good evening, Jyotish. All right. Jyotish says some issues with the sound. All right. Can you hear me? Hello guys, can you hear me? Hi Ravi, hi Harsh, good evening to you. Is the sound good? If the sound is good, we'll begin immediately. Hi Tiasha. Yes, it's always good to hear from sir. So shall we begin? You give me go ahead and we'll begin the conversation immediately. All right. Great. So let's begin the conversation. Now, firstly, are you guys able to look at what I am writing here? Good evening and welcome to Edutinews YouTube channel. You are going to get initiated into current affairs and gazette discussion for today, that is 7th of January 2000. 22. All right, so let's begin this. Good evening, Karthik. Good evening to all of you. Let's begin this conversation. Now, today the immediate discussion is on the snapshots, the important updates. Now, this is a topic from ethics and from current affairs both. This topic is on Mr. Djokovic. He has been one of the tennis stars, right, on the verge of having 21 grand slams on his name. And right here arises an ethical dilemma. Right, so we will understand what is this vaccine dilemma, vaccine hesitancy, or a necessity for people. The second topic is on Department of Telecommunication, which has released certain instructions for Internet of Things procurement. The third update is on new fly ash disposal policy. All right, okay. This day in history dedicated to Mr. Galileo. We will understand why so. Feature news is on a theme which has been a center of discussion for India for quite a while. You know, India has been rated as the internet disruption capital of the world. What a tag it is for it to receive. And recently, a parliamentary committee also reported on the suspension of telecom services and internet in the country. In this regard, this becomes very important to understand what is the current regime under which we suspend the telecom services in the country. What has been the impact of it? The impact is not only on controlling the disorder in the society, but also on economy, also on education, development. A lot of things are dependent on the internet services, especially during digital times. And we will understand in totality what has been the recommendation of the committee, what have been the norms under which we are suspending telecom services in India and internet in India. This is in the feature news for today. Interesting article, we'll cover it quickly, but we will understand the roots as well. All right. The next one is the image of the day. It is on a 10,000-year clock, a new clock which has been designed and has got quite some interesting features. Terms for today are, one, India to surpass China in ethanol consumption after USA and Brazil, two countries, USA and Brazil. The next for today is India votes in favor of United Nations Security Council resolution. What is this resolution about? Counterterrorism. We'll understand this. The third is crypto index IC15, which has been released. And the fourth is update on Kazakhstan. See, there have been international updates on a country like Kazakhstan. We have had updates from Sri Lanka going bankrupt. We've had updates from Sudan, lot of issues in Sudan. We've had updates from Myanmar. We will understand each of them one by one. We have covered Ukraine issue. We have covered several other issues. We will cover each of them one by one. All right. So today we have Kazakhstan issue. Editorials of the day. Today we have a mix of editorials from the impact of the lockdown and work from home economy. So smaller cities getting boost. Along with that, the hybrid work model. We will understand both of them together. And we will understand the article from international relations that relates to US-China, US-Russia meeting. Today's case is a very interesting case of a person who has created a bird refuge in Gujarat. So let's start this conversation. Good evening, Kriti. I'm sure that you guys must be tired, but I'm more than sure that this discussion is not tiresome for you, because we will regenerate ourselves through these conversations, right? A discussion on current affairs, what is happening around the world. So yesterday, one thing that I missed sharing with you was this, that Prime Minister's security has got three layers of security. This is how I wanted to explain it to you people. The first layer of security is through their PBG, personal bodyguards, PBG. And they are the NSG commandos, right? The second level of security is provided through Central Reserve Police Force. And the third level is by the local administration, the police. For example, Punjab Police, Delhi Police, Rajasthan Police, wherever the VVIP goes, right? So first level of security, second and the third level of security. This is what I was explaining to you yesterday. You could take a note of this. And this whole strategy is discussed with the state government along with the district administration. And to a certain degree, the DGP of the state, chief secretary are also responsible for every state, right? For the security of VVIPs like prime minister, president, vice president. All right. So let's begin the conversation. The first snapshot is on vaccination of individuals. Is it a collective good or individual liberty? Now, I had received a very interesting answer from Anonymous and Hema. I really like the maturity some of you present while answering. I look at the balance of opinions. So one of the persons who answered here, Hema, she said that yes, individual in democracy, it is individual liberty which should count. And collective good is also important, collective good, but it should fall down to individual liberty at the end. See, the point is, I'm not disagreeing with individual liberty or collective liberty. The point is the reason that you provide, both the justifications are correct, but just that they have to be reasonable. They have to be reasoned enough. This is the point. Now, the case in question is that of Mr. Djokovic, right? Novak Djokovic, an international tennis star from Serbia. I hope you are able to have a look at his image. Now, he is on the verge of winning 21 Grand Slams. He has already won 20 of them. And this equates with what Roger Federer and what another tennis star, Mr. Roger Federer and the Spanish star, can you name him the other one? Mr. Spanish. Can you tell me the name? Mr. Nadal. So these people have won, all of them have won 20 Grand Slams each. And Djokovic is currently titled as number one, and he is restricted at the gates of Australia to be entered into Australia. Why so? Because he has not taken the vaccine dosage, right? He has chosen to refrain from saying if he has taken the vaccination or not, and he goes through a rare condition because of which he cannot take the vaccination, right? And at the gate of the country, his entry was banned, right? Now, a short idea about the Grand Slam before we enter the conversation. Grand Slam titles are the four four matches that happen throughout the year. The first one is the Australian Open, then we have French Open, and then we have Wimbledon, and at last we have the US Open. These are the first one titled in the year. The first title to be fought for in the year is the Australian Open. This is this happens in the month of January, then French Open, and then we have Wimbledon and US Open towards the month of September, right? Now, all these are based at different kind of turf, right? So, while the Australian and US Open, they happen on hard turf. French Open happens on a clay turf. That is also called as Roland Garros. These are important data for pre-exam. And Wimbledon similarly happens for on the grass turf, right? So, we have Australian and US Open happening on the hard turf. This is the prime difference. French Open on clay, that is also called as Roland Garros. And then we have Wimbledon happening on the leftover, that is the grass, right? These are the turf. Now, here, the issue is that the person should have autonomy over their body or not. You need to know some technical words to be able to answer this. Vaccine hesitancy is one word, right? Another one is indemnity, indemnity. That means if the company is going to take liability in case there is some problems in vaccination or not. Vaccine hesitancy is one keyword. The third one is bodily autonomy. If you have these three or four keywords, you will be able to prove all the points. And this is what has been explained in this article. So this becomes a case of ethical dilemma. But many people who have not been, who have not taken the vaccination out of fear. There are many people who have not taken the vaccination because of certain other issues, for example, health issues. So with Mr. Djokovic, but he has been refused to enter Australia, and this has created a problem between international relations, between Serbia, the country he belongs to, and Russia, right? So John Stuart Mill, one philosopher, he has spoken about this. See, although this is ethics, but you can point out this particular name, John Stuart Mill. He always argues for individual freedom, but he also says that collective good is also important. So if individual liberty does not hamper the collective good, then individual liberty is good. But if individual liberty hampers the collective good, then it is this kind of liberty can be avoided. He takes a middle path. Now, taking vaccination, how good is it for collective good and how not? This is the choice that we have to make, right? So this is the debate that we have presented in the first snapshot. This is quite a philosophy-oriented article, something that you would relate to when you look at the essay paper also. But yes, you have to take a very practical stance towards this, right? So when you look at yourself being an administrator, you should look at both the aspects, right? Individual liberty along with the good of the masses, right? So if only few people take vaccinations, only few people avoid taking vaccinations, are they actually going to create a big impact in society, in the herd immunity or not? So you have to justify either of the points when you have a question like this, right? So this is how we can look at fairness, the virtues of fairness, integrity, amongst people and amongst the constitution of the country, right? So this is the first snapshot for you. A very ethical dilemma, but of course, you should also remember the fact that I gave you about the four turfs and when these events are held. If the person has won all the four titles in the same year, it is called as calendar grand slam in the same year, right? So Mr. Djokovic has won overall 20 titles along with two other players, right? One of them is Mr. Nadal, and the other one is Mr. What's his name? You guys tell me, right? So, okay, moving on to the second snapshot. What is it on? Today's second snapshot is on securing consumer Internet of Things, right? Now, if you remember, I had explained to you one of the ways in which people can connect with each other is through Internet of Things. They can connect to various devices. While I have given you the example of my relative, they were in India, based in a specific place in India, and they could connect to their home in Canada and connect to the cats that they had in Canada. The camera was placed accordingly. The food that the cats were to get, they were placed with automatic devices. Not only that, they could also regulate the nature's call, the poop of the cat. They were machines to regulate all of them. This is called as Internet of Things. Now, this is where the government, especially the Ministry of Communication, Department of Communication, has said that they will be regulating certain set of norms for the devices which have to be used for Internet of Things in India. Why not? We have to use these devices from trusted sources. Yes. So trusted sources is one of the keywords. Not only that, we should also look at certain more keywords. For example, mandatory testing. Mandatory testing. And another word is National Trust Center. This is what the government is going to form under the Ministry of Communications, Department of Communication. And they are going to regulate over the Internet of Things articles which have to be purchased by the country. Right? Now, there is going to be a boom of these articles, Internet of Things articles. Your mobile phone will be connected to your laptop, your electricity in the home, the geyser if you have, your vehicles, air conditioners, and in fact, just before reaching home, the air conditioners can start at the click of the button. So these are the kind of various advantages that that are available through Internet of Things. But India does not have the potential to create these devices, and that is why we need trusted sources. Right? Keyword. Do remember, these are the value of the things. The rest of it is story. Trusted sources. And then we need a proper audit, a proper mechanism for quality assessment. Right? Not only that, we also need certain more aspects of it. For example, creation of the National Trust Center. These are the keywords to use in your papers. Right? So this is how we are going to ensure that the attacks, the vulnerability on Internet of Things devices in the country, they minimize, right? Imagine globally, we will have 26 billion devices, 26 billion phone, laptops, electricity devices, bulbs connected to Internet of Things, 26 billion. And the population of the whole world will be less than 10 billion. So one person, we will have 2.5 devices for them. India also is going to grow in this regard. And therefore, what is important is to take care of this, right? Take care of this aspect. This is going to overshoot, and that is why we need to take care right now. And this is where I want to show you certain more keywords I have discussed. I wonder if you have written them, but you must note them down right now. This should be, if you're able to view this, this is an answer that I have written on security of internet, right? So you should look at these keywords, zero trust, zero access. If there is no trust with the particular device in Internet of Things, then zero access to that device should be provided. Keyword. Least privilege principle. If there are devices, if I have five devices, suppose I have a laptop, and I have an iPad, and I have a telephone, and I need to connect to, suppose, a Wi-Fi network, and my telephone connection will do the job, then there is no necessity of connecting my iPad and my laptop to that same connection. This is called as least privilege. If these devices are not required to be connected, don't connect them to internet. Otherwise, they will be more vulnerable to attacks. Data minimization. It means, example is IRCTC. It won't need our, many data. For example, my earning. It doesn't need my earning if I have to book a railway ticket. Data minimization. Multiple factor authentication, you know it very well. We are talking of two-way authentication where there will be one passcode on the device itself, and the second passcode will be the passcode that we enter on the particular website. Do remember all these four keywords, very, very relevant, all right? Okay, so getting back to the conversation that we were, this is going to ensure that there will be a better structure of Internet of Things in the country, right? So there will be no universal default passwords. Many a times, do we not have passwords which are set automatically and then we don't change them? No, we don't need that kind of structure. We need to ensure that people can delete the data easily after they have created the data, right? So right to be forgotten, please link with this, right? Minimize exposed attack surfaces, right? So we need to minimize through increased usage of the data structure that I just showed to you people, right? This will decrease the vulnerability, and we also need to test the devices that we are importing, all right? So this is the update from the second snapshot, right? And the major challenges is classification of devices. See, what are the kind of devices? High-risk devices, low-risk devices, middle-risk devices, they all have to be classified with each other. The risk of attack, the various kinds of attack, one is phishing, the other one is whaling. Whaling is an attack against people with a lot of resources, right? They can be blackmailed. Then we have phishing attacks against people where identities are stolen. We have attacks like malware attacks. Then we have spyware attacks. And then we have hacking of the whole system. So, and then we also have attacks where we, ask for ransomware. So risk of attack should also be known to people, the vulnerability. Timely detection, this is one big challenge. And ineffective security controls right now, right? So these are some important things that are required that are not available in our security infrastructure right now. All right, keywords, important keywords. And once you remember them, I assure you, you will be able to replicate them everywhere, right? So if you remember, there was a question, today there was a question on in the ethics paper that was on minimalism. Do you remember that? A question on minimalism and use of material devices. Right? Material devices, right? So these are the kind of material devices we are using, and this is where we need to protect ourselves. We need to protect against such kind of usage, which is threatening to our own personal space, privacy. Not only that, there was another question, which was on identity creation. Our identity, our understanding of our own self is through technological devices. So example is, the Generation Z, those people who are born very, very late, right? Those people who are born now have Instagram accounts, and instead of looking into themselves, introspecting, they view themselves as how others view them, how others talk about them on Instagram or Facebook or other places. So you can talk about the concerns of these, right? Concerns of those people in this new era. See, these are the keywords that you use, you can utilize. This is what Current Affairs Shabir sir was speaking a while ago. So if you have these keywords, then you have the upper edge. This is what you have to start learning to play with. But for that, you need a basic minimum tendency of having resources. That's where I'm helping you, right? Okay. Chitanshi asks a question. This is a part of science and tech or security? Absolutely, both of them. It totally, as I mentioned, you can use this in ethics as well. You can use this in essay as well. It totally depends on how you orient the words, the keywords in your articles, right? So science and technology, security breach as well. Absolutely, science and tech, both of them. But more preferred, if I had to ask a question, it would be related to security, right? Okay. All right. So, all right. Moving ahead to the next snapshot. Next snapshot is on the fly ash disposal rules. Okay. So these disposal rules have been amended quite a few times. The main thing is that, first of all, let me show you how fly ash looks like. The fly ash is this byproduct, right? This is the byproduct of burning coal in an industrial setup. This is fly ash, and this is very small particle. These are very small particles, and once they release in the atmosphere, they can cause a lot of issues with human health, right? Lung infection, a very, very common persistent threat this fly ash can cause. And what are the contents? It contains silica. Majorly, it contains SiO2. Then it contains aluminium oxide, right? Alumina. It contains iron. It contains magnesium, it contains many other minerals, and which are not good for human health, breathing as well. But it gets released in many of the coal-based thermal power plants, right? And we have 60% plus production of energy through coal-based power plants. So when this fly ash gets released, this is causing environmental damage. But interestingly, this fly ash can be integrated in India's economy because it has got these mineral products. These mineral products can be utilized in infrastructure creation. Imagine creation of roads with the help of these kind of minerals. It is going to be more durable. Imagine creation of bricks, fly ash bricks. These are part of India's policies, right? And this is where the government has said that there is a mandate of necessary utilization of 100% fly ash. 100% fly ash has to be utilized within a radius of around 300 kilometers from the place where that particular nuclear, the power station is there, right? The thermal power station. And if not utilized, then those bodies will be penalized. Now, although the better part is that government has declared that there has to be a deadline beyond which such utilization has to be mandated. But what about legacy ash? What is legacy ash? Legacy ash is the kind of ash that has that we have created over the past as of now. We will be able to utilize the ash that we generate right now, but huge lumps of ash that we have created, what about them? So the government has given 10 years of time to be able to utilize all this redundant ash and utilize them. They can create better structure, better embankments, better roads, better bricks. There are various other utilities. For example, in fertilizer, right? Is silica not used in fertilizers? Yes, it is used to maintain the balance of the soil. Is magnesium not used? Nitrogen not used? All of them can be used. Sulfur not used? Absolutely, all of them are used. So they can be utilized. The idea is to maintain an integrity in utilization of these resources. Okay. And another challenge here is that of the unaddressed fly ash that I already mentioned, right? The deadline that is 10 years, it is a very, very long time. And another issue is that of how about not even creating fly ash as a byproduct. If we have electrostatic precipitators, right? If we have fly ash capturing devices, these, they will not even get released. How about replacing coal energy itself? So there are various ways of solutions that are available, but right now government has said, this is the update from the end of the government, that better utilization of fly ash and its monitoring must be done. And if in monitoring it is found that there are problems, then the particular agency will be penalized. All right. These are the examples: manufacturing of bricks, tiles, cement, construction of roads, export, filling the low-lying areas like mines, agriculture, all the places. Right? Okay, great. All right, you guys with me? Everything good? Going smooth? Okay. The next this day in history is related to Galileo's moons. Right? So Galileo's moons. These are also the moons of Jupiter, the largest jovial planet on the solar system, largest jovial planet, gas-like planet, and it has got four moons. They were discovered by Galileo, one of the space scientists, right, one of the astronomers that we had, and we had a sequence of these scientists during the era of Renaissance and era of scientific temperament, right, in the medieval times. So one of them was Galileo, another one was can you name some? Kepler, and another one was Copernicus. All of them, in one or the other, said that Earth is not the center of universe. There are some bodies which are which Earth is also revolving around, right? Kepler mentioned this in his own way. So did Galileo, and so did Copernicus, right? But all of them were penalized in some degree or the other. Galileo was house arrested for this, and later it was actually so because there was a conflict between the interest of the church and the interest of the scientific temperament, right? So this is what is the update from here. And why are these four satellites called as Galilean moons? Because all these four satellites of Jupiter, Ganymede, Callisto, Europa, and Io, these four are have been discovered by Galileo's. And imagine, at those times, around 400 years back, this was a handmade telescope used by Galileo. What an interesting way, you know. Great, great achievement. And that is why we call it as Galilean moons. The largest of this moon is Ganymede. Okay. Let's move ahead. See, when it was explored that there are some satellites, some heavenly bodies which are revolving around another object, it means all these objects are not revolving around Earth. This proves that Earth is... This proves that there is something called as, there is something not called as geocentricity, geocentricity, and heliocentricity. Helio means sun. This is what was proved time and again by all these three people and then scientifically found in the later years. All right, great. Moving ahead to featured news, we'll discuss quickly after this session of current affairs is over. A very interesting topic on what is the reason that India is called as internet shutdown capital of the world. Imagine 75% of the resources that are wasted globally, they belong to India because of internet shutdowns, right? And most of these shutdowns have happened post 2019. What is the reason that this has happened lately? We will understand all of this. We will understand the rules under which the suspension of internet is done in our country, which are the places which are mostly affected, what is the impact of this on Indian economy and Indian society. And this is how we will understand this theme in totality, right? We will also understand the recommendations of the parliamentary committee. All right. So great theme. We will happily discuss this as well today. All right. These are very tough things to read when we read a monotonous article. But in conversations, this becomes quite easy to understand. Okay. So image of the day is interesting on a clock that has been built by Amazon founder, Mr. Bezos. One of the richest persons, in fact, the richest person in the whole world, and the second richest, who is that? Mr. Musk. Great fan. I'm a great fan. So this giant clock will have room-sized anniversary chambers, and this will not chime all the time. It will tick only once in a year. Imagine. And it will chime once per millennium. Right? What is a millennium? How many years is a millennium? Right. So this is how this clock is going to celebrate the various years, right, during the anniversary times. And this is the reason that it is called as a 10,000 year clock, right? Clock with high precision, which will conduct its time monitoring for a very, very long time. Interesting image, indeed. All right. Today's term and concept, the first term for today is on India, which is going to surpass China in ethanol production. Now, ethanol production, why is it in need in India? We're talking of ethanol blending of E10, 10% ethanol blending with 90% of petroleum. Then we are also speaking of E12, E15 and E20. You know, what are these? 20% of blending of ethanol, 15% and 12% of blending of ethanol with respect to the petroleum product. Now, what does it lead to? It leads to better burning of the petroleum. Better burning of the petroleum fuel. This also leads to less production of the polluting matter. And through this, we are also going to substitute the import. The import burden will get reduced. And ethanol is created through one of the products called as sugarcane. Sugarcane industry is very much responsible. So sugarcane industry, which has been reeling under pressure of international sugar prices, domestic sugar prices, it can provide its source to ethanol industry as well. Government is initiating this. See, we have the resources. The idea is to link them all. India is growing very fast, and these kind of linkages will help better integration of the economic supply chain. This will also benefit a lot of people who are in this industry, agricultural laborers, people who are in the sugar mills, right? Everybody. So India is supposed to become the third country by 2026 to use ethanol. A great feat for India, and the first one is USA, and then we have Brazil, right? So ethanol blending to 20% targets is a tough thing. Right now we can begin with E10, E10, E12, E15, right? And government has also changed the targets. Earlier the target was to ensure that blending must be done by the year 2030, but they changed it to the year 2025 at the beginning of this year. Okay, and by 2023, there should be mandatory selling of ethanol at petroleum stations. Now you can also see this is in the backdrop of India becoming carbon neutral by the year 2070. Great, okay, and this is how you see the consumption of ethanol blending. Right, all right, great. Moving ahead. So the second term for today, India voting in favor of United Nations Security Council resolution, which is on Counter-Terrorism Committee Executive Directorate. What is it? Now, see, if there is an office, there are directorate officers which are assisting in the running of that committee, right? So this directorate, India is going to lead the CTC in the year 2022. And India has said that we should continue with this directorate because this directorate is going to provide valuable information, content, support to this committee. Now, what is the reason for formation of a committee like this? This committee is very important considering the kind of terrorist activities happening around the world. Why? Because there is no global definition of terrorism, right? No unanimity in the definition of terrorism. This is where many advanced countries also fear what should be the definition of terrorism. For example, United States is opposed to the common definition of terrorism because it fears that its soldiers in Afghanistan or Iraq, which were there at some erstwhile time, they will be, they will be covered under this blanket definition of terrorism. Similarly, Russia is also concerned because it has also committed some kind of alleged human rights violation with Chechnya region. So many other countries are also objecting to the standard definition of terrorism. But this is required, and this is what India wants. Counterterrorism committee, India is going to head this year. All right. Crypto index, IC. Yes, 1,000 years, of course. Very good, very good. Now, cryptocurrency index IC15. Now, this index has been initiated by one of the crypto app, CryptoWire. See, what is the purpose of index? National Stock Exchange has also initiated an index. It has got initiated many index. Bombay Stock Exchange also initiates many index. Nifty is that of National Stock Exchange, right? 50 companies with the maximum market capitalization. Bombay Stock Exchange has 30 selected companies like this. It is called a Sensex, sensitive index, right? Similarly, this crypto app says that we will be benchmarking all the cryptocurrencies with the help of 15 cryptocurrencies. 15 cryptocurrencies in which Bitcoin is one, Ethereum is one, Binance Coin is one, Cardano is one, and there are many others. So total 15 currencies. And on the basis of this, people will be able to understand what is the stability level of the crypto market. All right, fine. So this is what you should know. IC15, right? So this is the first index in India that can act as a benchmark of the underlying cryptocurrency market and the performance. And it can be later on the basis of this currency, it can be linked to many other schemes, no? For example, mutual funds, right? For example, other indexed funds or exchange-traded funds, it can be linked to many of them. Now, one thing that you must know, that index funds and exchange-traded funds, they are almost the same. Mutual funds, if you know what is mutual fund, people put their money in a basket of places where, you know, this money can be utilized later. So if I put 100 rupees, 2 rupees will be utilized in say fuel sector, then 5% will be utilized in pharmaceutical, 10% in IT sector. So my money will be put in various sectors for investment, and they can be linked to Nifty. Right, so this is index linked fund. If it is linked to Nifty, if the Nifty rises, my money will be again put in the market, or it will indicate that the value of my money has risen. And if the value of Nifty has gone down, the value of my money investment also has down. This is index linked fund. Similarly, exchange traded funds are those mutual funds in which the trading can happen anytime. Usually in mutual funds, trading can happen towards the end of the day. End of the day value will be traded, and exchange-traded funds can be traded anytime. So this is the difference. Remember, crypto index IC15, going to help end users. Today's fourth term is on Kazakhstan. Now, Kazakhstan has faced a very, very critical crisis. 14 days of emergency has been declared in Kazakhstan. And the reason has been multifaceted. It has started with the rise of fuel prices. Now, Afghanistan is one of the countries which has got a very, very good presence of natural resources in terms of fuel. And yet this country is seeing fuel price rise. This started in the year 2011 when certain workers in oil province rich region, they opposed the rise in prices. And because of this, some of them also died in protest. And since then, the protests have been on. Now, this is one of the reasons. Another reason that you should see is that the government tried to make this economy of Kazakhstan as a free economy, not state-dependent economy, not state-controlled fuel prices economy. Due to this, the fuel prices rose, and due to this, the food prices also rose. There has been a revolt against this. Not only that, if you look into the backdrop of this, this is one of the erstwhile USSR provinces. 1991, USSR disintegrated. Kazakhstan was one of the independent countries, right? And since then, only one party has been ruling in Kazakhstan. Only one party. And the administrator, the president, when elections happened in the year 2019, the president, he instated another president of his own choice, right? And that current president, what has he done? He has, because of this crisis in this country, Kazakhstan, you have seen, I would like to tell you that in the largest city, Almaty, and then we have the capital of Kazakhstan. What is the capital? Nur Sultan. This is the capital, and another city here, an important city here, if somebody can name, Astana. So these are the important cities where a lot of rebellion has happened. In fact, the president's home also has been attacked. A lot of people have been killed. So president has now abolished the council of ministers, disbanded the institution of prime minister, reinstated another prime minister, but he himself has not replaced himself, right? So this is the issue. Now, this is where Kazakhstan has requested the forces from Collective Security Treaty Organization, CSTO. Remember Warsaw Pact, but it got absolved after the finishing up of USSR association. Now, this Collective Security Treaty Organization was formed between Russia, Armenia, Belarus, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan. Some Asian countries, some European countries. So they said that they will protect, the interests, security interest of each other. So armies have been called from those places. This is not a rebellion which is, as of now urged because of outside, intervention. It is internal based, and the protesters only said, old man, get out, old man, get out. So the idea is to have better administration, better democracy in a state like Kazakhstan. All right. So this is in Kazakhstan, internal security issue. All right, great. Moving ahead to editorials of the day. Three editorials, will quickly understand them and wrap them immediately. The first one is on booming small cities. See, you can include these kind of inputs in many, many places. Now, smaller cities have gained more traction of economy. You know why? Because people who are working in bigger cities, they have now gone back to their smaller cities, working in IT, working in industrial sector, MSME sector, service-driven sector, which can be worked upon online as well. So they're creating better demands in smaller cities as well. Better demands, right? I will be ordering Amazon product from my home, in my home city. I will be utilizing the internet services and needing the high-speed fiber connection at my home in a smaller city, tier 3 and tier 4 city. So this is something which is called as the exodus from the big cities, the big city exodus. It has got its own impacts. It has got plus points and it has got negative points, both of them. I'm sure you will be able to relate to it when we talk about plus points, right? So migration issue won't be existent as much, right? Bigger cities won't have to face the brunt of higher population rise. Similarly, there are advantages in the smaller city also. Look at the societal advantage. The parents will be able to stay with children, right? Many, many other advantages, right? Demand of service and manufacturing sector in smaller cities. Have you not demanded this, right? Yes. On the other hand, there are some issues as well, right? So handling all this is the challenge. This is what the first editorial talks about, right? So technology with eating out. Generation which wants to eat out every day, ordering Zomato and Swiggy. Entertainment options, right? So these are the things which people will start to order in the coming times, right? You can relate to all this when we talk about urbanization. You can relate to all this when we talk about issues relating to the urbanization challenges in the city. Just a bit. All right. I'm looking at my charging devices. Yes. Just a bit, friends. All right, let's get back. So this is the first editorial, interesting one. It also links to the second editorial, which talks of the issue that relates to the corona pandemic, especially the Omicron pandemic. Now, as when the world was emerging from the second wave, and this is where we have the third wave also linked to us, right? Now, this is where a lot of people are speculating whether there should be people who should be brought back to office, so work from office, or it should be a hybrid model, or it should be the model of work from home. See, work from home model, it saves a lot of real estate property rates, right? It saves a lot on the part of the company infrastructure. human resources in the company. People can work from home. On the other hand, it also impinges on the economy of real estate, on the employment in the country. Similarly, hybrid model is something that can, you know, have the cushion from both the aspects, that is work from home and work from office, both of it. So Omicron has given this new food for thought for employers. What should be the real model in which people can have a hybrid system of working? You can relate this to the first article itself, where we spoke of people going back to smaller cities and working from there. Imagine the kind of flexibility this offers to women. Women who are given the burden of working at home, they can get involved in both the aspects of life, social aspects and the family aspects and economy as well. They don't have to choose between society or finance and economy. Similarly, there are a lot of people who are waiting for offices to open, right? So this is how hybrid model will be able to help in these uncertain times. This is the second editorial, a quick glance through this. The third one is, development of satellite towns. Yes, Kriti. Hi, Sam. Good evening. All right. I will definitely look at the issue of sound that you people are saying, and we will rectify this. The third editorial is on US-Russia tango. Now, this is where we talk of the situation in Russia and Ukraine. Now, both these countries are saying that there must be immediate de-escalation of the conflict. Russia has demanded quite a few things. It says that, first of all, USA will not impose its security structure in Ukraine through NATO, right? This is one thing. The second one, it says that there will be no expansion of NATO towards East Asia, towards West Asia or Central Asia and the Eastern of Europe. This is second one. And the third one, it says, is that Russia says is that it wants necessarily that USA should not participate in those kind of military exercises which are closer to Russia's boundary, right? Now, USA is most likely going to accept some of them, most likely. Why? Because neither of the sides want war. Both the sides want peace, specifically because America has retracted or gone back from Afghanistan. It does not want to start a war front with Russia in Europe and with another one in China. Similarly, Russia also is an economy which is only emerging. Therefore, it would not want these kind of concerns. But yes, the kind of threats that they give to each other, they are quite something. So European economies and USA have said that Russia will see consequences like none seen ever. Right? This is the kind of threat that they give to Russia. On the other hand, Russia is hell-bent on ensuring that these three conditions are met for it. Right? How is it going to be advantageous? It is going to be of immense advantage to India, because if Russia and USA have friendship, both are allies for India. And both are, in a way, going to counter China, especially USA. And yes, Russia will have to choose slowly and steadily. So this is what is going to be an advantage for India in Asia-Pacific geopolitics. All right. Case study for today. A very interesting case study. Before we get on to it, if you like this initiative, share some love on us through likes, comments, and shares. Right? These are your blessings. You will be able to create better structure for current affairs discussion through your inputs. So, today's case study is on a gentleman, Mr. Bhagwanji from Gujarat. What has he done? He's created a home for around 2,500 birds. Home using earthen pots. Imagine this. If you can look at this image, there are times in winters and in rainy season, these birds do not find any host, any place they can live at. And these small pots, this is where the birds get in and live, right? This person has created this place out of his own money. He spent around 20 lakh rupees on this. Will you imagine? He has not studied. He studied only until fourth class. But look at the ingenuine efforts. Look at the ethics and morality of this gentleman, that he has treated birds at par with human life. Right, 35-year-old man, but look at the way he is trying to feed these birds, right? Trying to ensure that these birds have a life with dignity, right? Safe shelter during the times of winter, right? So this is how we understand what a beautiful bird house or bird bungalow this person has created. A great case study to use. And a few of you had asked me how to utilize these case studies, right? So let me show you one answer I had written myself. This is the answer on one question I had written. Learning gaps in children. If you see here, This is the case of rural India, right? I have written a lot of data here. The point I'm communicating is that rural India, ACER report says that 20% children have access to recorded videos, only 20% children, and 10% children attended live classes, example, in rural India because of the digital gap. So this is how you can utilize your other cases also. Let me give the example of Rupapara itself, right? Bhagwanji Rupapara. This is the case of creation of a bird bungalow. Residence for 2,500 birds. Natural techniques like urban pots. And then nature-based solutions for environment or fauna. So this becomes a case when you talk about environmental rejuvenation, and also include the name of the person or the place where it is happening. This becomes a case, it will provide value addition to your inputs in the particular answer. This is a part of answer I to take. This is what we are studying right now, but I just want you to know that this is how the case study can be utilized. We are not in answer writing here. Right now we are in current affairs. See, there are various ways in which you can gain data. We are trying to help you gain data. How to utilize them is an aspect which you will learn with time. This is what we share in Future News, right? So if you like this initiative, do show some love through likes, comments, and shares. We will quickly meet in the next video, that is on the Future News for today. And meanwhile, if there are some inputs, some feedbacks, I will quickly look at them, right? Provide them in comment section, and we will quickly deal with them as well, right? So thank you for your participation. And if there are questions, inputs, please put them down. Thank you. And see you in the Future News in a very short while.